place, that's this one here, isn't it?
And one needs to come off as well, yep.
Okay, so you can crank it around. There's a lot of shit you've got to take off.
Clear front line?
Yep.
We should be able to get there, won't we? Yeah.
Good?
Yep.
So good? Yep.
All right.
Okay. Where's the fronter?
Shouldn't be too far now.
So this is our design. Okay, so this is the design cam collar here. So as the cam collar moves down, and we this is full paper feed. Okay. So this means packages come is pulled down into the jaw. And when we make our settings, this gap here under the inductor bar will be our 0.5 gap under here. 0.5. So this is pre-correction, this is full paper feed, and anything in between is the correction range, okay? So this is driven by servo. Volume flap, so this is the cam roller, remember on the animations I showed last week, with the volume cam? So this here runs up on the volume cam, to close and open. So this is also driven by servo. Cam followers here follow cam profile.
Profile.
So the whole jaw system moves on cam profile. And the jaw gap, when we make the jaw gap, by cam profile. Okay? So firstly, remove the volume plate. Remove this one here. Under here, we have a screw. So you need to remove this. Don't relieve the spring tension here, no need to.
Okay.
And here we have a when you're working on A3 speed, you need a lot of rags. You get fucking greased everywhere. Ah, edit that, fuck it, I didn't mean to say fuck. Okay, sorry, fuck edit out.
Take two.
As Kulopong would say, this is just a cover.
Cover.
Then we pull it out there. UV lamp?
Yeah.
Okay, this is just a cover. Okay, so two more here. You need to take those.
Remove the screws 1 and 2. On. And on there.
Yep.
That's off. Take the blue bit off. Yeah, underneath you have a spring.
Spring?
Yeah.
And a
dead
screw.
And a locator. Here. Okay.
Okay.
So there's no need to remove this spring.
Because we're not changing it?
No.
Alright, so we'll go straight to spring pin 5, which is in.
So now,
here.
I bet you we didn't have any pin punches.
Pin punch.
So you need pin punch. Same as this. Okay. Because I need to take these out to show you. this. We have a torque wrench, don't we?
Yeah, but only for this one.
Yeah, we don't have this one yet. We have a torque wrench. But not the one we ordered last week. Mm. Well, 2 Newton meters. We don't have that. Because everything on the jaw system has to be torqued.
Everything.
Because here we have a screw. And on the screw here, it says A480. Okay? A480?
Yeah.
Easy to cross it, eh?
Yeah, very.
I'm just thinking,
okay.
Because this is also new.
Yeah.
Okay, so we need to just work it in a little. So then this will go all the way, like this. So when you put it in here, you need to make this all the way home. If you don't make it all the way home, when you pull, you'll strip the threads. So make sure it's all the way home. Okay? So then this goes in here. Okay. So then this here will then sit like this, over here. Okay, and then this will just locate up against here. So but first, you need to read the book how to use this. Right, now we'll do your, while you're away, I'll just show the people how to use this.
Yeah, yeah.
This is for moving, just removing the shaft. So this would sit in here, like this. But when we screw it in, it needs to go all the way home. Right, all the way to here. If you don't thread it in all the way, then when you pull it out, you'll strip the thread.
Yeah.
So this needs to go
all the way. Is this only on dual team?
No, this is for
all of them.
Yeah, but here they're all fixed. I don't know why the one at the training school is perfect. One of the loose.
Folding flaps.
Yeah.
I asked you.
You just want to hold, mate.
Because I couldn't remember.
Not remember all these ones, mate.
Mate?
Those of you who aren't tall enough, well, we need a ladder. Because you need a ladder to set it. You can't set it here. You need a ladder to look down.
Oh, yeah.
0.7 here, 0.5 here, 0.6 here, 0.8 here. You measure at 0.5. It's the tightest point. If you measure at 0.6 and try to make it closer, then this now becomes 0.2. Then we start to get damage to the pack. You always measure on the tightest point. Okay? All right? Now that you've removed this, and part of the service also will be to lock this pin up and remove this cam follower and put a new cam follower in. Okay? Now we can remove this shaft. So a special tool, if you go to the page, find out how to use this.
We'll leave it back here for you want.
Okay, so now you need to hold and then you undo this. So now this hits up against here. Just tighten that screw up. I have a laser guided thing to see if anything goes on the packaging material. Mm-hmm. And sometimes, one time, insects flew into the factory. All these insects between the laminations on the factory. Okay, so now, have you replaced the camp on?
Okay. It is. And then, also, there's another hole here. Okay. Comes on the end.
Okay.
All the way through. And then this, then, goes...
goes on through there.
You can see, all the way down.
Okay. Oh, okay, to there.
To our final folders.
Our
folding flaps.
Okay. Folding something.
Yeah. So this one and this one feed the folding flaps. This one's just for the bearing.
Just for the bearing.
Yep. Okay. All good?
Can follow a bearing. Awesome.
This is one whole piece.
Okay.
So this comes up against the shoulder here. But if we but if this is pushed off, then it needs to be put on in the right spot.
Yeah.
Okay, so now you can push this. Remember you have these two washers here, okay? So you need to make clearance for these.
Yeah, yes.
Okay?
Yeah.
So they've got a flat spot on one side, so they sit in the right spot.
Yeah. Oh, okay, cool.
So they don't rotate.
Yeah.
Ready, eh?
Okay.
Keep going.
There was the
that's the
it's
home position. It doesn't mean you're standing here and now you hit the fucking shit out of it. So now just make sure we have rotation.
Home position.
Home position.
Home position.
Okay.
Yeah. Just bring a torque wrench.
Because if you don't, you will break it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Easy.
You can see that happening.
Yes, you have a torque wrench. From here down. Okay. So while it's in here, then we have the pulse, the ceiling pulse. 180 milliseconds pulse, time it's in here. Okay?
Yep.
So if we put it back down again,
see along here we have to have an air gap.
Yep.
Okay, so this cannot be touching this. So we have to have an air gap. You want to hold it back up again like that. And when we come down, here we have to measure this distance here, here, and here, and here. Okay, we measure the air gap. So, not more than 2.6 and not less than 2.2. Okay, so I'll show you, and we'll show you how to measure this. Lock off. And then, no, you have a grub screw here and a grub screw here. It pushes on this block.
Okay.
So if you push this way, then you will move this one further. If you push this way, then you move this one. So this grub screw here and here is just in here. This is beveled. So when the bevel is pushed down, it will separate. Mm. And if we undo the screw, the bevel will push up and not come close. I don't want to pull all this apart, okay? All right? Then they're talking about sideways movement, shim, here. So if you want to adjust sideways, you can also adjust the shim here, okay? But this is adjusting the position of this valve to this surface and to this surface, mm-hmm. Here, okay? See? Underneath. Put your shim this distance from here to here to the surface. Here. Okay, so the shim here. That's why you don't undo the center blocks. Put the four outside ones. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
It's quite heavy.
You should be the most gentlest out of all of us, all those kids. Master.
What made you think I'd look after my kids, eh?
Well, you've been a paternalistic.
Clip it in.
Come down a little. Come down, 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 come down. Into that gap there.
Slip it in.
Okay. Now, put this on, but do not tighten. So the two together.
You can put
a bit of pressure on it. Right.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so if you can get to this one, yeah.